Hello everyone. So here in this problem, we have to find out the partial fractions for the given fraction. Now, if you'll observe the given fraction, then here in the denominator of the given fraction, we have x plus 5, which is a linear factor, and we have a term x square minus 1, for which we can find out the factors. So I'll rewrite this term as x minus 1 and x plus 1. So I am applying the formula for x square minus 1 and x plus 5 as it is, x plus 3 as it is. So in the denominator we got 3 factors, and if you will see, then all 3 factors are linear factors. Also the 3 factors are different. It means here I will say we'll solve this problem by the method of distinct linear factors. So let's start. So here I'll say by partial fraction, we'll say this x plus 3 upon x minus 1, x plus 5 as a upon x minus 1 plus b upon x plus 1 plus c upon x plus 5, and I'll say this as equation number 1. So now we'll solve this equation number 1 to get the value of a, b and c. Then we'll substitute the values over here in the equation number 1 and we'll get the partial fraction of the given term. So let's start with it. So first of all, I'll find out the LCM on the right hand side. So the LCM of this right hand side is x minus 1, x plus 1 and x plus 5. So all these 3 terms will come in the LCM. Now if you'll observe the first term, then here x minus 1 is there, but x plus 1 and x plus 5 is not there. So I'll multiply the denominator and numerator of first term with x plus 1 and x plus 5. So here it will become a into x plus 1, x plus 5. Similarly, if you'll observe the second term, then in the denominator of the second term, we have x plus 1 term, but x minus 1 and x plus 5 missing. So we'll multiply the numerator and denominator of the second term by x minus 1 and x plus 5. So this will become b into x minus 1, x plus 5 plus, if you'll see the last term, then x plus 5 is there, whereas x minus 1, x plus 1 missing. So we'll multiply the last term in the numerator and denominator by x minus 1 and x plus 1. So this will become c into x minus 1, x plus 1. Now we'll copy down the left hand side, that is x plus 3 upon x minus 1, x plus 1 and x plus 5. So now if you'll observe, then we have the x minus 1 on the both sides in the denominator, we'll cancel it. Similarly, we'll cancel x plus 1 and x plus 5 and we'll rewrite the remaining terms. So therefore we will get x plus 3 equal to a into x plus 1, x plus 5 plus b into x minus 1, x plus 5 plus c into x minus 1 and x plus 1. I'll say this as equation number 2. Now we'll substitute the different values of x to get the value of a, b and c. So now I'll tell you one trick to find out the value of a, b and c. So the trick is, whenever we want to find out value of a, we will try to make this b and c as 0. So once this b and c will become 0, we can get the value of a directly. Similarly, to find the value of b, we'll make a and c 0, and to find value of c will make a and b 0. So let's start with it. So first of all, we'll find out the value of a. So to find out the value of a, we have to make this b and c 0. So to make this B and C 0, we have to make the proper substitution. Now, if you'll observe the brackets which are given with B and C, then here this X minus 1 is there with B as well as with C. And if you'll observe, then this same bracket is there in the denominator of A. So it means whenever you want to make this B and C 0 or the other constants as 0, then make this X minus 1 as 0. It means whenever you are finding, let's say, some variable A, so that time its denominator will make it as 0. And by doing that, we can bring the other constants as 0. So here I'll assume this X minus 1, that is the denominator of A at 0. So when I'll assume X minus 1 as 0, I will get X as 1. So by substituting X as 1, I can make B and C 0. So that will get the value of A. So here I'll say, put X is equal to 1 in equation number 2. So by doing this, we'll get 1 plus 3 equal to, this will become A into 1 plus 1, 1 plus 5. Now here, this will become 1 minus 1, that is 0, and 0 into whole term is 0. Next here, 1 minus 1, again 0, so this term will also become 0. So we got B and C as 0. Now let's find A. So here we'll get, therefore, 4 is equal to, this will become 1 plus 1, 2, and 1 plus 5, 6. So 2 into 6, that is 12. So 12 A. And to get A, we'll send this 12 in the denominator of 4. So therefore, we will get A as 4 upon 12. And that is nothing but 1 by 3. So the value of A is equal to 1 upon 3. So to get the value of A, we assume the denominator of A at 0, and by that we got one value of X which we have substituted in equation number 2 to get the value of A. Now similarly, to get the value of B, we'll assume the denominator of B at 0. Now the denominator of B is X plus 1. If I am assuming it as 0, then I will get X equal to minus 1. So by substituting X as minus 1 in equation number 2, we will get the value of B. So here I'll say, put X is equal to minus 1 in equation number 2. So this equation number 2 will become minus 1 plus 3 equal to, here minus 1, X is minus 1, so minus 1 plus 1 will become 0, and 0 into the whole term is 0. Here we'll get B, minus 1 minus 1, so B into minus 1 minus 1. Here we'll get minus 1 plus 5, so minus 1 plus 5. Again in the last term, here we'll get minus 1 plus 1, that is 0. So the last term will also become 0. So therefore, we'll get 2 equal to B into minus 2 into 4. And this will become minus 8B. So therefore, to get the value of B, we'll send this minus 8 in the denominator. So we'll get 2 upon minus 8. And by solving this, we'll get the value of B as minus 1 by 4. So now let's find out the value of C. So to get value of C, we will make the denominator of C as 0, or we'll assume the denominator of C as 0. So when we'll assume this X plus 5 as 0, that time we'll get X as minus 5. So now we will substitute X equal to minus 5 in equation number 2 to get the value of C. So here I'll say, put x equal to minus 5 in equation number 2. So this equation number 2 will become minus 5 plus 3 equal to, now here x is minus 5, so minus 5 plus 5, that is 0, so first term will become 0. Again minus 5 plus 5, 0, so the second term will become 0, and here we'll get c into minus 5 minus 1. And here minus 5 plus 1, so minus 5 plus 1. So by solving this we'll get minus 2 equal to c into minus 6 minus 4. So by solving this here we'll get minus 2 is equal to 24c. So to get the value of c, we'll send this 24 in the denominator of minus 2. So we'll get c as minus 2 upon 24, or we can see therefore c as minus 1 upon 12. So we got the value of a, b and c. Now we'll substitute value of a, b and c in equation number 1 to get the partial fraction. So here I'll say, substituting values of a, b and c in equation number 1. So the equation number 1 will become x plus 3 upon x minus 1, x plus 1, x plus 5 is equal to, now here it was a upon x minus 1, so the value of a we got as 1 by 3, plus b upon x plus 1, we got the value of b as minus 1 upon 4, plus c upon x plus 5, and we got value of c as minus 1 by 12. So now we'll solve this, or we'll bring it in the proper format. So if you'll observe, then here the denominator of the term c is 12. So here I can make this denominator as 12 by multiplying it with 3, and I can make it as 12 by multiplying by 4. So first we'll rewrite this. So this will become 1 upon 3 times x minus 1 minus 1 upon 4 times x plus 1 minus 1 upon 12 times x plus 5. Now we will take 1 upon 12 common. So by taking 1 upon 12 common, here to get 1 upon 12, we'll multiply the numerator and denominator by 4. So this term will become into 4, so 12, and into 4 here we'll get 4 upon x minus 1. Next, to make it 12 here, I'll multiply this term by 3. So I'll multiply the numerator by 3. So this will become minus 3 upon x plus 1. Similarly, here already we have 12. So we'll take 1 upon 12 outside and we'll get minus 1 upon x plus 5. So this is the partial fraction of the given fraction. Thank you.